Hey everyone, if you're new to Photoshop or you just need a refresher on Photoshop if it's been a while, I just got done recording a 10-part video on how to use Photoshop CC 2018. And if you watch this in the future, I think it's still going to be relevant because Photoshop really doesn't change all that much from version to version. So a lot of this is still going to apply. And in these videos, I basically broke them down to be less than 10 minutes each and walk you through all the steps of getting started and getting comfortable with Photoshop. So in the very beginning, we'll talk about how you set up Photoshop, all about file formats, and then getting started. And then we'll talk about all the tools, layers, working with exposure, for example, in images, design, text, everything that you need to know from the beginning to kind of the intermediate level of getting around Photoshop. So not too advanced. The whole thing is not going to be more than a couple of hours. And in the description, I'll put a link to all the individual videos that are in this 10-part, and if I add to it, I'll add that to the link. So if you look in the description, you could jump around, and if you're familiar with tools, for example, or if you're familiar with layers, you don't have to watch that video and you could jump around. But make sure in each video you stick around to the end and the next video should automatically play. And if you want to learn something about Photoshop that's not here, you could go to Howfinity.com and there is over 100 videos all about different things that you could do in Photoshop. And we're adding new videos about Photoshop there every week. And also, if you subscribe to this channel, I post about Photoshop all the time. All right, let's jump into the computer here. With the very first video, I just want to get you comfortable with Photoshop and getting started with Photoshop, creating a very first project and moving around in that project. And then we'll take it from there. And again, make sure you subscribe because I'll be posting videos about Photoshop all the time. And if you like, you could check out Howfinity.com for more. All right, let's jump right in. So if you haven't downloaded Adobe Photoshop yet, you could go to the Adobe website. I have a link in the description. You could go on here and you could buy Photoshop. You could try the monthly plan or you could buy a yearly plan. And you could also buy the entire suite for $50 a month with the yearly plan. And if you're a student, you could get it for $20 a month for the entire suite. And that's what I have. I have the Adobe Creative Cloud, which has all the applications here. And in this video, we're going to focus on Adobe Photoshop. But if you're going to use other things, like I use Adobe Premiere a lot, I use Adobe After Effects, InDesign, Lightroom. So this Creative Cloud really gives me the best option possible. All right, so let's launch Photoshop and get started. Adobe Photoshop 2018, that's the version that I have right now that I'm going to use. And when you launch Photoshop for the first time, it's most likely going to be on the Learn page right here. But this is my work page. Obviously, I've been using it. But it doesn't matter what you see because we'll start from scratch. So when you open Photoshop, the first thing you want to do is you want to create new. So we're going to click here and create new. And in this video, I'm just going to walk you through how you create a project and how you navigate around that project. So when you create new, it's going to show me my recent files. Obviously, you're going to see something different here because this is just customized to my recent, but you don't have to choose any of these. You could go to photo here and you will see some of the presets that you could choose from, or if you're doing things for mobile or film or video, you could go on this tab. So all these different tabs give you different options, or you could create your own by customizing one of these, and you could always change one of these. So this is not that important that you get the perfect dimensions right now, but just for the sake of this video, let me show you what I usually use. Because I often create assets for video, this is the dimension that I always look to, which is HD video, 1080p, 1920 by 1080. So let's say you were in one of these and you click this one. The first thing you want to do is you want to name your document. So I'm just going to name this one. And the dimensions, again, they're the presets, but you could type these in. Maybe you want a square file, so you could do 1080 by 1080, for example. That'll give you a square file. But this pixel dimension is for HDTV, so you could change the orientation. And pixel is usually what I go with, but you could do inches, centimeters, and other things. But if you want to follow along, just go ahead and create one in pixel. Resolution, now, if you go for print, you want to go to 300 pixels per inch. Now for video, 72 is fine, so I'm going to go by the default. RGB color is fine. I'll get into this stuff a little bit later. 8-bit, everything's fine. Background, you could choose transparent backgrounds or you could do black and white background. So in this case, I'm just going to do white and I'm going to press create. So that's how you create a file from scratch. So if you wanted to create a file from scratch and then start designing on this, that's how you get started with creating a file. Another way is you could go to File and you could go to Open. And I have some files here that I wanted to show you. So if you wanted an image in Photoshop, that's an easy way to open an image in Photoshop. You just go there, File, Open, choose your image, press Open. And it opens it in a different tab. My file that I created, my document I created is here. And the image I just opened is in a new tab here. And this is how you play around with the tabs up here. You could grab a tab and move it and make it first, so then this becomes the second tab. You could also move a tab and bring it out, and it'll create its own floating tab like that. And you could always drag it over here and let it go, and it'll nest it with the other images you have up here. Let me open another one, press open. And this time I'm gonna open a Photoshop file that I have already created. If I press open here, again, it creates a new tab. So now I have three tabs, the blank document I made, the image I opened, and this Photoshop file. And as you could see, this Photoshop file is already finished. So these on this side of the page, these are my different layers that I've created. So if I turn some of them off, you could see things turning on and off. If I turn the image off in the background. So again, this may look a little complicated now, but I'll get into creation of all these in a little bit. But for now, I just wanted to show you how you open different documents in Photoshop and how you maneuver around each document. Let me show you one more way to opening a file in Photoshop. I'm just gonna go to Photoshop CC here and go to Quit Photoshop. Again, on a PC, some of these things may be in a different place. I believe under File Quit on a PC, the place where you quit Photoshop. But again, I'll go to Photoshop CC, Quit Photoshop. I'll just say don't save. I don't need to save. And another way is if you have photos or files stored that you want to open. In this case, I have them on my desktop. These are the three files that I had on my desktop. I could click one and I could right click or control click on a Mac and I could say open with Photoshop. That's another way just to open it before Photoshop is even launched. This launches Photoshop and it'll open that document just like we did before. So instead of going to File, Open, I just open it that way. So let me show you a different one. This one is a PSD file. So this one should already by default be set to Photoshop. So if I double click this, it should open it in Photoshop just like that. And here's another one, open with Photoshop. This by default is preview, so I had to do that. And this is just another image to open. So Photoshop is meant for different types of people doing different types of work. So in a case, if you want to retouch an image, I'm gonna show you that in one of the videos. In this case, it's just a YouTube custom thumbnail. I'll show you how to create something like that from scratch. And some people even use Photoshop to design things that are much more complicated, like this image. Although there is some other software that allow you to do things like in Adobe Illustrator, it's meant for creating assets like this one, creating logos. Those are usually created in Adobe Illustrator, but Photoshop does give you a lot of things that you could do here. Just to show you what's possible in Photoshop, if you come up here on the right side and you click this arrow, it has different layouts for different people. So Essential is basically to help you get started, but if you were doing painting, for example, you could go and create painting. It's going to change everything to be more painting based. So now you have brush options, color swatches, a whole different layout. If you go over here to photography, you're going to get different things for photography to make it easier to adjust exposure and things like that. And even for motion, if you're doing things with motion, it's going to have a different layout to it. But in this case, I'll just go back to Essential. A lot of times I'll live on Essential for basic things. Now, once you have your image open, let me just show you how you get around this image, okay? And I'll get to a lot more photo retouching and asset creation in the later videos, but this video was all about getting around in Photoshop. So let me show you a few things of getting around with an image. My favorite tool is the Move tool, which is the default tool that's selected here. So over here, these are all your different tools and they all have a keyboard shortcut. So I'm just clicking and holding and these are my keyboard shortcuts. So in this case, the Move tool is a V. And if I press V on my keyboard, I'm gonna get the Move tool. So by default, I have the V. Just to show you a different tool, I'll show you the Hand tool. So the Hand tool, again, I'm holding it over and it's showing me what the Hand tool will do. But the keyboard shortcut for it is H. So I'm gonna press H here and now I get the Hand tool. But these are right now, these are not the tools I'm going to use to get around this image. So a tool I like a lot to getting around an image is the zoom tool. So the zoom tool or Z, if I press Z here or select the zoom tool, I get the zoom tool. And if I press here, it just zooms into my image just like that. And if I press option, it gives me the minus zoom so I could zoom out. And depending on where I hold it, it's going to zoom out in that way. So again, zooming in just like that, option or alt gets me back to zooming out. But my favorite keyboard shortcut for that is command minus to go out, to zoom out, and command plus to zoom in. And command zero makes it full screen, and command one makes it at 100%. So let me go ahead and command minus just to be able to see my whole image. And just down here on the very bottom of the page, you see this size, this is the zoom size. So right now I'm at 33%. So when I press command one and it took me to 100%, that's why my image looks bigger than before. So now if I click the hand tool, I should be able to move around this image anywhere around the image that I want to. And it actually does this nice thing where it keeps scrolling for you, and then you just click and hold to pause it there. So the hand tool allows you to move around, and the zoom tool, or the shortcuts with the zoom tool, allows you to fit this to size or however you want it to fit on your screen. The move tool is more for moving assets and different layers, and I'll get to layers in a different video, but the move tool is not the right way to get around an image. The hand tool is the right way to get around the image, and the zoom tool. So zooming in and using the hand tool to moving around within that image. And then I'm gonna just press command zero to fit to size. And fit to size, again, on my screen, it was at 50%. I'm on a 27-inch iMac, but depending on your computer, things might look a little bit different. And down here, the dock size, you could always click here and hold it, and you'll see the resolution and width and height of the document that we created. In the next video, I want to go over some of the tools that you see over here. So this is the toolbar right here, and I'm going to show you what some of these tools do for your document and for your image. Before we get to the next video, please give this one a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next video. Keep watching.